Gallium has two stable isotopes, and the masses of gallium-69, which is 60.11% abundant, and gallium-71, 39.89% abundant, are 68.926 AMU and 70.925 respectively. You know what respectively means? It means that we've got two masses here and two atoms here. So respectively means the first of these masses goes with the first atom mentioned, and then the second one of these masses goes with the second atom mentioned. So don't let that term throw you off. So that's what respectively means. Anyway, calculate the average atomic mass of gallium. So to do this, we're going to want to take the mass of the first isotope, multiply it by its percentage expressed as a decimal, and then we'll take the mass of the second isotope, multiply it by its percent abundance expressed as a decimal, and we'll add the two of them together. So we will start with gallium-69. So what's its mass? It's the first one here, so respectively, we're going to use the first mass. It is 68.926. And now we want to multiply this by gallium-69's percent abundance, but expressed as a decimal. So we'll be moving the decimal place two spots to the left, times 0.6011. That's the first part. Now we're going to want to do the same thing for gallium-71. So its mass is the second one here, 70.925. And we multiply it by its percent abundance as expressed as a decimal. Move this place two to the left. So we get 0.3989. Multiply both of these together and then add them up. And what you're going to get is 69.72 AMU for the average atomic mass of gallium. Now, if you wanted to just check your work, you could look gallium up on the periodic table. Here's what it would look like. And underneath the element name is the average atomic mass, which matches what we just calculated. Now, very quickly, check this out. We have two isotopes of gallium. One weighs about 69, the other weighs about 71. And the mass is closer to 69 than it is to 71. And that makes sense because there is more gallium-69, 60%, as compared to gallium-71, which is only about 40% abundant. So it makes sense that our weighted average should be closer to this one that's more abundant than to this one, which we don't have as much of. Rubidium has two isotopes, rubidium-85 with an atomic mass of 84.911 AMU, and rubidium-87 with an atomic mass of 86.909 AMU. The atomic weight of rubidium reported on the periodic table is 85.47. And in this question, when they say atomic weight, they mean atomic mass, relative atomic mass, any of these terms you can use interchangeably. Based on this information, which of the isotopes of rubidium is more abundant? And we're talking about, is it rubidium-85 or is it rubidium-87? And how do you know which one is more abundant? This is a thought question where you don't really have to do any calculation. And it revolves around the idea of relative atomic mass, atomic weight. So now how does this relate to these two isotopes? Well, we have rubidium-85, which weighs pretty close to 85 AMU. And then we have rubidium-87 that weighs pretty close to 87 AMU. So for these two things, the regular average, if we had the exact same amount of both, would be right in the middle. It would be 86 AMU. But instead, we can tell from here and from the periodic table that the atomic mass of rubidium, the weighted average, isn't 86, it is 85.47 AMU. This means that it's closer to the mass of rubidium-85. It's not in the middle, and it's not close to 87. So that means that the weighted average is telling us that we have more rubidium-85 because this weighted average number is closer to this. So there's more of this that's pulling the weighted average number down. So rubidium-85 is more abundant because the atomic mass weighted average is closer to that than it is to this. Magnesium has three stable isotopes, calculate its average atomic mass using the information in the chart below. We've already done this with two isotopes, but you can do it with as many isotopes as you need. It's the same process throughout. So let's start with magnesium-24. We're going to want to take its mass, which is 23.985, and multiply it by its abundance, expressed as a decimal, 0.7899. That was magnesium-24. Now we're going to go on to magnesium-25, take its mass, 24.986, multiply that by its abundance as a decimal, so 0.1000, okay? And then finally, magnesium-26, 25.983 times 0.1101. I fit it all on one line. So we're going to do this math, and we're going to end up with 24.31 AMU is the average atomic mass, and you can check yourself by looking it up on the periodic table, and you find that the reported atomic mass is the same as what we calculated here.